All right. Next, I want to talk about the supercharger capacity. And this is kind of a big deal. And let me explain why. So Elon tweeted this just the other day, saying that the Tesla supercharger capacity will double by the end of next year. Expect to be within range of 95 to 100% of population in all active markets, which is a lot of markets. And so this is, we've heard this before. He originally tweeted something else about the Supercharger V3 coming out. And Fred from Electric asked him, you know, regards to the 350 kilowatt, which is the speed at which the charging happens. And because I believe Porsche now has one like that. Elon responded saying, you know, a mere 350 kilowatts. What are you referring to? A child's toy? So more superchargers, higher end superchargers. He later walked this back and basically between him and JB on the Q1 earnings call said that that they wouldn't be able to do this because it would affect the battery's ability to maintain a charge. So essentially what you're saying is, would you rather have, you know, and I think the example they used was the cell phone, would you rather have your cell phone charge in, you know, 30 seconds and only last 2 hours, or would you rather have a charge in 15 minutes and have it last, you know, 15 hours or whatever? So they walked this back after originally saying that it would be super, super fast. And then, you know, the V3 version, the new version, they speculated would be between 200 and 250 kilowatts. Again, that's the speed they're talking about. That is about double of what you see of these Tesla superchargers here, which are 120 kilowatts. And now these chargers, the normal superchargers that are out there now, not the urban ones, the smaller ones, these share that 120 kilowatts between two of them. You can see there's an A and a B on there. That means that if someone else is parked there, then, you know, you're going to be sharing that charge. It means you're only going to get about half, 60 kilowatts. And so that's why if you're at a supercharger and you didn't know that, it's kind of rude to park right next to somebody in the B stall if there's an open one. You know, it's going to be better for everybody involved. So this new V3 would be double that speed. Now, that's interesting to see. I'm curious how it's going to play out. You know, previously they had said that they would release V3 this summer, and now it looks like it's going to be end of year and then next year. So, you know, we'll see kind of what happens here. But I just wanted to talk about the growth of the supercharger network in spite of all these kind of things that are coming out there. Because they've said this before, and there's a really cool website here called supercharge.info, and they have some data, which I gently removed from their site or copied into my little workbook here. And let me just pull that up and show you some analytics that I put together for you based on the actual supercharger network. So let me go back here. All right, so if you look at the supercharger network growth, essentially there was hardly any in the first year, and then they started to grow. And then now we're at, according to supercharge.info, and this is a community-driven site, so this isn't official data from Tesla. I have reached out to Tesla asking them, can we have this data? Because I think the community-driven approach is kind of silly, especially something at such grand scale here. It's going to be impossible, really. You know, we may be able to figure it out other ways, but it would just be nice if they just put this data out there. I don't see why they wouldn't. It's just, you know, a list of all the superchargers and the stalls. If they just had essentially that same data feed, you know, I could build this map off of that and it would be the actual data. So according to this data, they're at just under 11,500 stalls. And so some, you know, some places will have 5, 6, some of the really, really small ones. Other ones will have 40 or 50 stalls. So this is kind of the trend. And you see that at the top here, it kind of tailed off. You see that? It kind of slowed down a bit. And so I did the same chart here, but now by year, looking at the growth. And of course, in the early years, you know, you're going from hardly any to a good number. So the growth percentages are massive. But you can see the growth in 2018 was actually slower than 2017. And so for Elon to say that they're going to double that next year means they have some aggressive plans here. It means that there is a lot of money that they're going to be investing into this. And I do think that's really good because the superchargers are incredibly useful. Not only are they good for road trips, but for a little short stopover, maybe if you're driving around town or something like that and you need to keep going, the superchargers offer a really great way to kind of extend your trip. I just recently used one of them on a trip I was on where we spontaneously went and drove to the mountains, stopped at a supercharger, got all the way to the mountains. Fortunately, there was a destination charger. If you follow me on Instagram, you'll see some photos from that trip. But I'm hoping that what Elon said is true. I'm hoping that the supercharger network does grow, does double. I believe their 2018 goal was 18,000 superchargers. And so to be at 11,500 is quite a bit short of that. So we'll see. Obviously, I'll keep tabs on the data for you so you don't have to worry about it. And we'll kind of keep track of it and just see how it grows. And I'm really curious how it feels to you. If you are a Tesla owner and you use the superchargers on a regular basis, a lot of people don't. A lot of people just charge at home. That's over 90% of the times most people are charging. However, some people, it's their only option, especially if you live in a city like New York where you don't necessarily have an option at home. I'm curious how it feels to you. Does it feel like the network is growing? Because that perception will play a big role in kind of all of us and when we're talking about it. So let me know what you think. Leave me a comment. I'm very curious to hear how that's going.